men of Texaco. We work from Maine to Mexico. There's nothing like this Texaco of ours. Our show tonight is powerful. We'll wow you with an hour full of howls from a shower full of stars. We're the merry Texaco men. Tonight we may be showmen. Tomorrow we'll be servicing your cars.
I wipe the pipe, I pump the gas, I rub the hub, I scrub the glass.
I touch the clutch, I mop the top, I poke the choke, I sell the pop.
I clear the gear, I block the knock, I jack the back, I set the clock.
So join the ranks of those who know and fill your tanks with Texaco.
Sky Chief, fill up with Sky Chief, and you will smile at the pile of new miles you will add. Fire Chief, fill up with Fire Chief, you'll find that Texaco's the finest friend your car has ever had. And now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing America's number one television star,
who's just been a Roman all around the country, Milton Berle!
Now you know what you look like. How do you like it? There's an awful draft around here. Anybody got a hunting license? What are you waiting for? How do you like this? Isn't it wonderful what you got to go through for a lousy $15,000 a week? Isn't it murder? The Greeks had a word for this. And if you don't know the word, ask President Truman. It is really... thank you, Democrats. It is really wonderful. I want to tell you, I wore this. You've heard of cruising down the river? Looks like they dragged me out of one. I want to tell you, I wore this on account of the springtime. Lovely. Yesterday was the first day of spring. I knew it. I woke up. I found a blue jay at the end of my corn. But hurry up, please. I can't hear myself. I got the wig on. You've heard of Julius Caesar? I'm his brother, Sid. Sid Caesar, another show. But I want to tell you, it's spring, and I love the springtime. It's really wonderful. I know it's spring because next week they're going to spring my brother. But this is really the truth. He was just arrested for having flat feet. They found his feet in the wrong flat. But this is really thank you, your name and address. This is really... No, I'm kidding. My brother, is he money mad? No kidding, he's mad every time I don't give him any money. I'm not kidding. I got a brother that's afraid to go to sleep. He dreams he's working. But this... He dreams he's working.
Hurry up!
This is only an hour show. I got to get it all in. This is... But I want to tell you, Milton, you're wonderful. You're wonderful. I don't know what you got, but whatever it is, get rid of it. This is really... I feel good. No kidding. I love this weather. I was in the park. There's nothing like getting up at 6 o'clock in the morning, take a long walk around the park and taking a cold shower. There's nothing like it. So why bother with it? I want to tell you, it's really... I was in the park this afternoon. It was gorgeous. The birds were flying. The trees were sighing. The sailors were trying. You know, it's remarkable. Don't applaud. I do this as a sideline. I do this so I can eat. Speaking of eating, I would like you to meet a man that eats today like there's no tomorrow. Chubby boy, Alan Roth. Let's give him a hand. Come on. Isn't it cute? Take a boo. Look at that stomach. Well, that's what we use for belly laughs. You know, it's... He's on a diet, too. From the front, he looks like Sidney Greenstreet from the back. But you're on a diet, aren't you? He just rubbed 3 cafeterias off his list. But this is really the truth. Oh, this I gotta... Hold the music, will you? This is the truth. Alan's been... I gotta laugh at this because I heard it. Alan has been gone with a girl steady for 10 years. Okay, so the other day she says, Alan, let's get married. She says, all right, but who'll have us? You know, it's remarkable. This man. But, Mom, wake up.
Mother is sleeping. But I would like, ladies and gentlemen, to introduce the first show. And we have a wonderful show prepared for you. And it looks, you know, I can tell when I walk out here that if we have a good audience, I can just look around the audience and see if they're appreciative. Good night. So, ladies and gentlemen, on with the show. May I present to you, oh, these lovely. May I present to you one of the greatest acts of its kind on the stage today. I'm sure you're going to hear a lot about them. May I present to you the Lascados. Come on, let's bring them on. Here they are.
Thank you.
Lady, where'd the audience go? Oh, there they are. I would like to introduce... Lovely suit, isn't it, smart? I'm not even going to have it altered. Ladies and gentlemen... Oh, speaking of suits, it is a great thrill for me to introduce a gentleman, not in show business, but I'd like him to come out and take a bow. His picture just recently was in Esquire, where he was the designer of the new spring suit, ladies and gentlemen, for the men for this coming year. May I present to you Mr. George Van Dorn. Come right out here and take a bow. The new spring suit. Was an ad lib he did there. And now, ladies and gentlemen, speaking a very fine gentleman, it is a great thrill to introduce a gentleman making his first appearance on television, just come in from California, Charlie Chan's number one son, T. Luke, ladies and gentlemen. Luke, pleasure to have you here this evening for Texco Star Theater. We have very wonderful audience here. Everybody love you in Scream and very happy to welcome you here.
This glorious moment, I'll remember till the end of time.
He speaks with a broken Chinese accent, I think.
Yeah, you fool me. I didn't even know you spoke English.
Well, I didn't know you did either.
Thank you. Now, Key, please. You're not... This is your first television show.
Yeah.
But we have a very wonderful crowd watching you from their homes, and all the little boys and girls are watching. They've seen you on the screen. And I want to tell you, you've never been on a comedy program, have you?
No, I haven't, but someday I hope I will.
Yeah, I was... Look, number one son get a number one shot in the head. But I want... No, this is really a comedy program. And, of course, you know I'm heard all over. You know that.
Yes.
You hear me? All over?
Well, I never miss it.
You never miss it?
I never see it, so I never miss it.
I had trouble with Laurie last week. I don't have any trouble. Don't worry, I do very well. Did you read the article in the Saturday Evening Post about me? The Texaco Company are very happy with me. You see, they want a very big publicity stunt on Milton Berle.
Yes.
They want to make the country Milton Berle conscious.
Yes, but first they'll have to make Milton Berle conscious.
Yeah. Yeah. This gentleman is an Oriental Henny Youngman, this man. Oh, don't kid me, you know. I'm heard all over the world, you know that.
Yes,
you,
I know.
You know that?
Yes.
I'm also heard in China.
Oh, yes, you
know
are.
That, don't you?
Yes, yep. In fact, they want you to make a tour over there.
They do?
Yes, I just got a letter from one of my relatives.
Gee, as if this wasn't rehearsed. You did... They want...
Yeah, oh, yeah.
They want me to make a tour, and
yes.
It says that in the letter?
Oh, yes.
Let me read it. It says, Dear Key, just heard Milton Berle's radio program. Why don't Berle come across with some jokes? What do you mean, a tour? Now, wait a minute, man. My programs do play in China. You know that.
Oh, yes.
All but, over. You know.
But you know, they're not exactly you because we have to get them translated into Chinese.
They translate my voice? My voice?
Yes.
Do you know something, Mr. Luke, that I speak Chinese very fluently?
You speak Chinese?
He has
like a straight man.
Oui. That's French?
Yes.
I speak French, too. How do you like it? Well, I want to tell you, I speak any language, but I want to tell you, you tell them about what you told me before the show went on,
yeah.
About the Tabby, right?
Yeah. Oh, he's marvelous on television, you know? But you know, my good friends, in China, we also have television. Of course, it isn't exactly quite like what you have here, but we, too, have our great television stars. In fact, I've inveigled two of them to appear on the show with me tonight. And so, ladies and gentlemen, with your kind permission, the Texaco Star Theater proudly presents the top television show of China.
Oh, we're the men of Texaco. We work from day to Shanghai. Just as loudly like this Texaco of ours. Our show tonight is powerful. We'll wow you with an hour full of powers from a shower full of stars. We're the merry Cantonese men. Tonight we are Far Eastmen. Tomorrow we'll be servicing
fry the rice, I roast the duck.
I spare the rib for half a buck.
I bread the shrimp, I boil the tea.
I soy the bean for chop suey.
Egg roll, fill up with egg roll, and you will smile at the pile of new miles you will add. Chow mein, fill up with chow mein. You'll find that chow mein is the finest food your car has ever had. And now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing China, number one television star, Ming Tung and Bernie!
Again, among the Yangtze boys we know. Dear ones greeting us, finally meeting us with a fun hello.
Hello, everybody.
Hello, Ming. Hello, Bling. Although it gives us pain to pop.
Yes, yes.
We'll come back knowing if we knew the words, it would be all right. From your mother's egg roll.
My partner, he say, America, wonderful place.
Yeah, man, I say to Etamakayasadu, Halava, Etamuguyado, Isadongi, and I say to.
My partner, he say, American girl, beautiful.
We were wow here, oh.
My partner, he say, he want a mule join his pyramid club.
Pyramid club.
1 yen.
1 yen. You bring 2 yen, we have 8 yen older guys. That's a wow.
Yeah, now special.
Why you?
Yeah, my...
Special?
Yeah, special.
Special?
Extra special.
Oh, I'll kill you.
My... My partner now do implausible trick.
Implausible me, yeah. I do impossible
trick. He jump 6 feet in air, turn flip back somersault, jump through hoop of fire, and land on one leg.
You got the wrong boy.
Oh,
yeah.
Don't be Chinese schmo.
Don't be Chinese schmo. He had living good tonight.
What do you want, joke?
Yeah, joke.
Tell joke. What about like joke?
Joke.
Yeah.
Ming Tun.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Why do Chinese firemen wear red suspender?
Why do Chinese firemen wear red suspender? To keep his pants up.
Ah, Ding Hao. Ding Hao.
Come here, I want to speak to you. Tough audience. Here, go ahead. You tell another yoke, you know, another one.
Yeah. Ming Tun.
Yeah, oh.
Who was that Mandarin? I saw you with last night.
Will you repeat that for the West Coast?
Ming Tun.
Yeah, well.
Yeah, who was that Mandarin? I saw you with last night.
That was no Mandarin. That was a ukulele.
Ding Hao, Ding Hao. Special.
Come here, I want to speak to you. We got to rehearse in the basement. Another special imitation.
Yeah. Imitation.
Yeah.
My partner, I give you imitation of one pair long underwear, meet one pair short underwear on street in Shanghai.
One pair long underwear, one pair short underwear, meeting on street in Shanghai. Okay?
Okay.
Let go. Yeah. Hello, Longy.
Hello, Shorty.
Come here, I want to speak to you. I think we better go now.
Well worth knowing that we'll come back, knowing that we will come back up. Your father's fried rice, so we'd like to get you up from the China.
Star. Ladies and gentlemen, no, I'm not the star. The star that we have tonight
is coming on right now. And a great star, ladies and gentlemen. Been seen in more Broadway successes and has more Broadway successes to her credit than I think any grand singing comedian and great star that we have on the main stem today. Ladies and gentlemen, a great thrill to present to you the, I call her the queen because she is, the incomparable, the inimitable Ethel Merman, ladies and gentlemen.
On the Texaco Star Theater with Milton, and I'd like to sing for you a number that I had the pleasure of introducing in a show, Anything Goes. I get a kick out of you. My story is much too sad to be told, but practically everything leaves me totally cold. The only exception I know is the cat. Number that I had the pleasure of introducing in my first Broadway show, Girl Crazy. It was written by the late and the great George Gershwin. I got rhythm. I got rhythm. I got music. I got my man who could ask for anything more. I got daisies in green pastures. I got my man who could ask for anything more. An old man trouble, say I don't mind him, 'cause you won't find him round my door. I got starlight and I got sweet dreams. I got my man who could ask for anything more, who could ask for anything more. Who could ask for anything more?
is fun being here on the Texaco show with Milt. Really, I just feel so wonderful and so happy. Maybe it's spring fever. I don't know. I just feel like getting in my automobile and taking a ride out in the country somewhere. Well, that reminds me. My automobile is waiting for me. I can't keep it waiting. I'll be right back. Now, listen.
My lovely darling, Emmy Lou. She's adorable. She is my melancholy baby. She's got a head like a melon and a face like a collie. there she is. Darling, Emmy Lou, my darling. Darling, Emmy Lou. You look adorable, darling.
Oh, Clyde.
Darling, I've been waiting to take you in my jalopy. Isn't it lovely?
What kind of a car is it?
Ask me that again.
I said... What kind of a car is it?
Here it comes, folks. A hardly able. Beautiful job, too. Lovely. It's a five-passenger job.
Yes, I know. One drives and four push.
Give me a shot there. Yeah. Beautiful car, though. Lovely car. Beautiful car, my darling. It's got an automatic choke for backseat drivers. It's not very old. It's a new car, darling. It's not old. It's not old at all.
It's not old?
Yeah, it's Carney Upholstery's turning gray. Carney Upholstery's turning gray. That's the next joke. The Carney Upholstery's turning gray. That's the next joke.
I'm trying to say it. It's so old that the hair in the upholstery is turning gray. See?
Come Oh, my darling. Oh, they're not making these the way they used to, are they? Oh, darling, you and I shall go in the car. I love you, my darling. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you, and there isn't anything that you wouldn't do for me.
And that's the way we've been going through life.
What, darling?
Not doing a darn thing for each other.
Come here, dear. Oh, don't say that. It's not true. If you're ever in a jam, here I am. Oh, have a trouble and you're in jail, I'm your bail. It's friendship, friendship, just a perfect friendship. When all the friendships are soon forgot, ours will still be hot. La 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 la, ding ding ding. La 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 la, ding ding ding.
If you ever lose your way, come to me.
I'll do that, my darling. And if you ever need a cop, call on Pop.
And if you ever take a boat and get lost at sea, write to me.
Hey, it's friendship, friendship, just a perfect friendship.
When all the friends have been forget,
yeah, yeah,
I will still be here.
A la 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 la, chuck chuck chuck. A la 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 la, chuck chuck chuck. If you ever have trouble, look out me.
And if you ever catch on fire, send a wire.
Let me tell you, Emmy, and if you ever lose your teeth when you're out to dine, borrow mine. It's friendship, friendship, just a perfect friendship.
When all the friendships have ceased to gel.
Yes, yes.
Friendship, 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 friend
so jazzy. And now, ladies and gentlemen, may I introduce this time a young fellow that will show you what happens on any street in the United States. Here he is.
All right, now, friends, just a minute. Through the courtesy and kind permission of the Texas Company, Texaco, Pennsylvania, I'm going to offer for the first time my new and imported meatballs. Now, friends, these meatballs contain nothing but the purest ingredients to wit. Each and every meatball contains 20% gutta percha or liquid rub. Now, because these meatballs, friends, happen to contain a rubber center, they take away the ease on the body and take away the rough and make it very simple for you. Now, you don't have to knock your brains out, friend. If your kitchen happens to be close by, don't carry in the meatballs. Just take them one at a time and bounce them in just like that. Now, suppose your kitchen's a little further away from the dining room around East St. Louis. In that case, I recommend my old slingshot method. Just take the old hamburger this, put it right in the slinger, and give it this business right over here. Why, yes, Bud, what about?
Well, what about a little ketchup?
Ketchup, you ask. We'll have it cleaned in the morning, kids. Don't worry about it. Now, at each and every one of my meatballs, friends, I'm going to throw in one of my new self-starting automatic razors. Now, friends, these razors work by the electricity that's conducted in your own body. You simply take it, plug it in your kitchen like that, and it works. It's marvelous, friends, and each and every one of them, it's working when I ain't even got it in my mouth. But it's guaranteed to get rid of your whiskers, friends, and leave your skin nice, smooth, and clean. Just the way Haviland Motor Oil, friends, gets rid of the excess dirt, sludge, and carbon from the motor of your automobile. It keeps it running smoother, it keeps it running better, and it keeps it running a lot longer. And believe me, friends, this here particular oil, what I'm talking about, Haviland, has a dual-fold purpose. By that, I mean Haviland's a modern motor oil, friend, that cleans as it lubricates. All right, you say you're not satisfied. You say you want more for your money. All right, just a minute. Tell you what I'm going to do. Now, friends, I happen to have here an elk's tooth with a cavity in it. Now, if any of you guys want to join a union, you want to join a... Just a minute. Stop the sale. What is it, Bosco?
I'm a clock.
You're a clock? Well, what time is it?
8 o'clock.
You're a little off the beam, kid. It's 8:30.
I must be a little slow.
I kind of want to have no... Hey, wait a minute, kid. I know that kisser. Ain't you Joe Young?
Yeah.
Alcatraz, 1, 2, 3, 4?
Yeah.
Don't you remember me? Sid Stern, 1, 2, 3, 5.
Sid
Stern. Hiya, Joey. I'm with a...
Small world.
It's nice seeing you,
hey,
Joey,
Sid,
boy.
Tell me. What are you doing? You still pitching?
Why, certainly, kid, I'm still pitching, but this time for a great outfit, Texaco.
Yeah.
The Texas Company, kid, and they got some wonderful products. For example, today I'm laying emphasis on Texaco Fire Chief Gasoline. Why, Joe, that's an emergency power gasoline that sells at regular gasoline prices. What is it, Joe?
Tell me, how is the wife, Sid?
I'm glad you brought it up, kid. We just took a second honeymoon.
We
had a wonderful time, kid. We got into the old horse and buggy, the kid and I. We started to go up the main road about 8 miles an hour. She wanted to go a little faster. I got the horse into a canter, then into a gallop. Said, kid, I want a little bit more speed. I says, anything you want, kid. I put my foot on the accelerator. The car shot forward, going about 40, 50 miles an hour. I seen something on the highway around the Union Turnpike. Put on the brakes. I had a blow while I went in the back. Got a hold of my Jack, I was just
a minute, Jack.
Yes.
What happened to the horse and buggy?
You're a little bit corny, kid. Horse and buggies went out with ruffled skirts 20 years ago. I was riding in the automobile with my wife.
No. You told me you were in the horse and buggy.
Now, Joe, I don't want to argue. I haven't seen you in a long time. I happen to say I was in an automobile.
No. You told me you were in the horse
and buggy. All right, let's not argue, kid. We'll prove it one of the geese in the crowd. Anybody hear the argument over here?
Yeah, I heard it.
Well, that's fine, kid. Now, tell me, was I saying that I was in a horse and buggy or was I in an automobile?
You were in an automobile.
Two brothers and a stranger.
Yeah, never mind. Hey, by the way, Bub, do you smoke?
Yeah.
Well, there you are. Have a cigar. Thanks. Not at all. Hey, where was I, kid?
Well, he said you were in an automobile.
Yeah, thank you very kindly. All right, we were in Mustangs.
Yes.
We were going down the main highway about 50, 60 miles an hour. The kid says, give me a little bit more speed. She knows I was a Bonnie Oldfield kid.
Yes.
I give her everything she wanted. But before we went on the honeymoon, I knew what I was going to do. I drived into one of them Texaco filling stations.
Yes,
filled her up with that Texaco Fire Chief gasoline, Joe, because I know you can always get an instant reaction and immediate pickup when you got Texaco Fire Chief gasoline.
Yes.
And you get it just when you need it. We were going along about 50, 60 miles an hour. Says you want a little bit more.
Yes.
I give the gun everything it had. All of a sudden, I felt a spray of water hit me in the kiss of the boat, started to capsize. Man, overboard. What are you worrying about, kid? I can swim.
What happened to the studs?
Hey, look, kid, they haven't made that car in the last 40 years. You paying any attention to me, Bug?
Look, you just told me you were in an automobile, the studs. Now, what happened
to
the
studs? Wait a minute, Joe. I was in a motorboat. I got to make a pitch for Texaco. I ain't got all day time to waste with you, kid. I was in a motorboat.
No, you told me you were in the studs.
All right, we won't argue. I'll prove it with the guy over here.
Hey, George Washington.
Never mind. I don't want to have no trouble. Now, kid, you heard the argument over here, didn't you?
Yeah.
Now, what was I talking about? Was I talking about an automobile? Was I talking about a motorboat?
Motorboat.
Thank you, Bub. You're a gentleman. Do you smoke?
Yeah.
I hope you burn.
Yes. Hey, kid, have a cigar. They're two for a quarter.
Yeah, you got the nickel one.
Yeah, that one. All right, kid, I said I was in the motorboat. Is that right?
That's right.
All right, we were going on Biscayne Bay. We were looking for a little sailfish. Wife and I was having a wonderful time. We're trying to get a little smoked salmon.
Yes, my luck.
No. It's close by. We were going having a wonderful time. All of a sudden, she wanted to go a little bit faster.
Yeah, yeah.
We were having a wonderful time. The spray started hitting me somebody's head. Look on the port side. There's a submarine coming. Man, the periscope. Take a look in the periscope, will you, kid? What do you see?
Same darn thing.
Ah, you're not looking right. Well, we had a wonderful time. All of a sudden, we were going past the fence. You wanted to go more? I give it the gun. We dropped up 20, 35 feet up in the stratosphere. All of a sudden, the propeller fell off. I threw it
out. Don't get up, Doc.
What's the matter, kid?
What happened to the motorboat?
What are you talking about? I was up in an airplane.
No, you told me you were in the motorboat. I ought to.
Wait a minute, Joe. I don't want to have any trouble with you. I'll prove it.
Yeah, no. This time, I'll prove it.
Oh, you know some guys around here?
Yeah, I got a lot of friends around here. I'll prove it with Alan Roth.
Alan Roth?
Alan, where was he? Was he in a motorboat or was he in an aeroplane?
Motorboat.
There you are. By the way, Alan, do you drink?
Sure.
Well, have a drink on me.
Sid, I want to buy his new record that he just made. It's called, I'll Tell You What I'm Going to Do. He made a recording. Thank you very much, Sid. Same darn thing. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to introduce at this time, and I take a great deal of pride in presenting this young boy because I feel, though, he's my discovery. I think that he's wonderful. I was down in Greenwich Village just the other night, and I went to a place called the Savannah Club. By accident, I walked in and saw a young boy dancing. In my estimation, I think he's one of the greatest young dancers that we have today. I'm going to leave it to you, because it's usually the public that make the performers. Ladies and gentlemen, 20-year-old Teddy Hale. Here he is.
wonderful.
You know, when I hear that music, Alan, your playing of that music is wonderful. You know, music does so much to soothe the savage beats. Not only that, music hath charm. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to tell you something. This great street of Broadway, where all the song publishers are and the music business is, we can really thank for bringing us some of the greatest music in the entire world. Yes, there's no place like Tin Pan Alley, ladies and gentlemen. No place like Tin Pan Alley. With Milton Berle, member of ASCAP. Yep, there's a lot of great names in this book, ladies and gentlemen. A lot of great composers. And we're very, very thrilled tonight to have them on the Texaco Star Theater. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present to you Songwriters on Parade. My cohorts, my pals, it is my pleasure to present to you first a young lady and a young gentleman that have rapidly risen to the heights in the music business, one of the great young song teams. Pleasure to present to you lovely Joan Whitney and Alex Kramer, ladies and gentlemen.
Where we put the accent on the wrong syllable. Imagine you imagining that you love me. Imagine stepping on a family tree. The papa is you, the mama is me. If your heart goes bumpity bump, it's loud, loud, loud. And if your throat comes up with a lump, it's loud.
It's love, just love. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Joan and Alex want you to hear the song that they just composed, which is now the number one song in the entire nation. Here it is.
Go into China.
These are the songs that all these folks composed. Now may I introduce to you a grand guy who has more song hits to his name and to his credit than possibly anyone in the music business. He's at the piano right now with his lovely wife, celebrating their 25th anniversary, incidentally. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Charles Tobias.
The rainstorm puts your rubbers on your feet. Comes fire, then you know you want to be. Comes love, nothing can be done. Rose all day, rose all day. Rose all day, rose all day. You're my Philly-ca-doosh, shinnamaroosh, a ball of roller, boom tootie, boom tootie. Boom tooty, boom tooty, I miss you. I miss you more than I can say, dear. Tell me, do you ever miss me? As I miss you, don't sweetheart me. If you don't need it, don't say goodbye. If they're not true, time waits for no one. It has to be fine. It rolls on forever, like the clouds in the sky. No can do, no can do. My mama and my papa say I know she do. No can do, no can do. I want for me to go with you, but no can do. He made the night a little brighter. Wherever he would go, the old lamplighter of long, long ago. Don't sit under that apple tree with anyone else but me. Anyone else but me. No, no, no. Don't sit under that apple tree with anyone else but me till I come marching home. This is still my favorite, and I hope it's one of yours. Will you join me in singing? When your hair has turned to silver.
Playing memories. You hear that, memories? And it's very memorable right now for me to introduce a number that was written in 1896, ladies and gentlemen. A number called Sweet Rosie O'Grady. And the Texaco Star Theater is very thrilled to have the writer here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Maud Nugent. Here she is.
O'Grady, and Rosie O'Grady loves me. such adorable. What are you playing? Good news?
Oh, boy, I'm lucky he's playing. And we're very lucky tonight, ladies and gentlemen, to have one of the great, great tune writers in the world. This gentleman has written more hits. Well, I said that about Mr. Tobias, but I will repeat, as Burl usually does. I will say that about this gentleman. Ladies and gentlemen, a great thrill to introduce, and at the piano, another very famous songwriter, Ms. Doris Tarbell, who's written so many big hits. May I present to you Mr. Lou Brown, ladies and gentlemen.
The moon belongs to everyone. I'd be lost without you. I saw you last night. I got that old feeling. When you came in sight, I got that old feeling. Button up your overcoat. When the wind is free, can't take good care of yourself. You belong to me. We strolled the lane together, laughed at the rain together. They heard the breeze in the trees humming weird melodies, and they made that the birth of the blues. Oh, don't make it serious. Life's too mysterious. You work, you slave, you worry so, but you can't take your dough when you go, go, go. Now, ladies and gentlemen, will you all join in and sing? Come on, Al.
Another song written by the famous team of the Silver Brown of Henderson, and here is lovely Ethel Merman to sing the hit song of the show, Varsity Drag.
Many a class, whether you're dumb or wise, if you all hands are called, when you're
Yes, here we go.
Curtain is descending and we thank you for attending, but before we reach the ending, may we add, remember to be loyal to our gasoline and oil. When they save you time and toil, you'll be glad. Now the clock is striking 9 o'clock, but just before we sign off,
tomorrow night, listen to the Milton Berle radio program, also presented by your Texaco dealer.